The landscape of AI software development is rapidly evolving, with new AI app builders emerging every single day. While numerous platforms battle for users' attention, there are two in particular that are fan favorites of builders and founders, Tempo and Replit. Let's attempt to build something with both using similar prompts to compare the output. To begin with, we're going to visit tempo.new to start to create our book list tracker. I'm going to paste my prompt and hit generate and let Tempo generate our application. What you can see here that's unique to Tempo is that it's creating the product requirements document. You can see it planning here the product requirements. You can see it planning the user flow, and it's creating diagrams for the user flow. So it's providing all the background context for the application. After the creating the product requirements document, what Tempo does or attempts to do is create the designs and the wireframes. But as you can see here, there are a few errors. On the free version, I have about 5 or 6 prompts altogether. And you can see I have 4 prompts left today. Following the design, we can see the code on the code tab, where we can view the code, we can edit the code, we can prompt it to make some adjustments to the code. The preview right here is very hard to see, but actually when we go to the preview in a new tab, we can see the application as a user would see the application. Immediately, it opens our application in a new tab, and it opens this modal. This is not exactly as I would want it, but I think this is still okay for a one-shot prompt. It seems I'm unable to close this modal. When I click the close, it doesn't close. When I click cancel, it doesn't cancel. When I click add book, it seems to add the book, but the modal still doesn't close. So there are some functionality errors with my one-shot prompt. I'm going to prompt Tempo to add any missing functionality, such as closing the modal. After adding the missing functionality, we can see that it has improved the preview wireframes to actually be previewable, if that's a word. And if we go and click open in a new tab, hopefully it's added the functionality that was previously missing. Here it's improved, so the modal's not the first thing that opens. Let's see if we can delete this. So we can delete books. We can add books. If we attempt to view the books in the list, let's see if that works. I don't think that works by this button. This button works. This button works, but the top one doesn't. And also, this is double functionality. So we have 2 buttons that do the same thing. The last thing we're going to do is try to prompt it to change this UI. We want to use a glassmorphism effect, and we're going to see how Tempo handles that. Tempo has created this glassmorphism effect, even though the background is a little bit distracting. Let's take a look in a new tab. It's not too bad. It is different to what it was before. The background is using a stock image, so we can always change that image. But it seemed to be able to handle UI changes pretty well. We can see some additional features that many AI app builders are beginning to implement, such as being able to upload files and attach files, being able to pick elements and add context to change a particular element. Here we're using Claude 3.7 Sonnet, but we could change to Gemini. This is super interesting that we also have reasoning and the ability to chat only. I love to use this sometimes just to go back and forth on ideas based on the code base and based on what changes I actually want to make. And it's great they added a chat only functionality. Tempo also has suggestions, so we're going to try to use that now. The AI has analyzed the code base and suggested some suggestions. So some are code related suggestions and some are functionality related suggestions. So we can see add reading progress tracking here. It says implement data persistence with Superbase, which is a good segue to lead on to some of the features on this sidebar. We can integrate with Superbase, which is awesome. We can also edit locally, so we can connect this to Visual Studio Code, potentially Cursor and some other platforms to be able to edit locally. The integrations with Figma are amazing, especially if you're coming from a design background and you want to make your prototypes a lot more interactive and actually work as applications rather than just be clickable prototypes. With some of these other features such as App Store and Design System and even using Git settings and Git, I do believe Tempo is going down a more developer-centric route, meaning this is a lot more complex than many other tools, especially Replit. Now, let's take a look at Replit and give it the same prompt and compare the two results. To experiment with Replit, you're going to visit replit.com and paste your prompt in the dialog box. Before Replit makes the application, it creates a plan, and you can see that we have to approve of this plan for it to get started. Now that Replit's ready, we can see a preview of our application here. The first thing we're going to do to test this is try to add a book. And we have our book added. We're going to add another book to see if this sorting functionality works. Something I do notice is that when I add a book, it doesn't add immediately. I need to refresh the page. And that's probably because it's not using no persistent memory used in a database. All I'd have to do to add the database is prompt it to add the database, and it will add a fully managed database within Replit. We're going to attempt to sort this, so let's sort it by the rating. Okay, we know that works. We know sorting by the author works, and the date added should be the same. Let's test the search functionality. And lastly, let's test the status. I'm going to go ahead and try to delete this, and you can see that it is missing functionality, so we would have to keep prompting Replit to add this missing functionality. What you'll be able to see here is we can attach a file just like Tempo, and we can also select an element. So let's try to add the functionality to delete on this alert dialog box. Replit has made those changes, and you can see it's suggesting us to add a database. If I try to delete this now, it has given us a weird kind of type ABC to confirm the deletion. So we're just going to do that. And nothing happens. So we would have to keep prompting Replit to add this functionality, which is a very, very basic functionality. Next, we're going to try to make some adjustments to the UI to use that same glassmorphism effect. I personally think this design is much better using the glassmorphism effect. Let's take a look at these applications side by side. Although it's not as easy, you can import designs from Figma directly by using the attached file. If we go back to Tempo, it had the Figma extension, it had Connect Superbase to make it really easy, and even local editing. We don't have all of that here with Replit. I mentioned that we can use Replit's internal database, which is a bonus. If we take a look at Tempo, it doesn't seem like Tempo has an internal database we can use. To manage versions, we would have to roll back. So you can see roll back here. If we go back, we can roll back here. With Tempo, we can also restore to previous versions. If we take a look at Git, we can also use Git to restore previous changes. To deploy this application, all we have to do is hit deploy, and Replit is hosting this for us. Whereas with Tempo, we click share, and we have to deploy this to the Vercel, or we can also deploy to Tempo hosted deployment. Hopefully you were able to see the advantages and disadvantages for each in a side-by-side comparison for a basic book tracker application. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or there's anything you want us to cover in the future, please leave a comment below. Be sure to check the link in the description to go to No Code MBA, a learning platform with dozens of in-depth, high-quality courses on no code and AI taught by industry experts. And be sure to subscribe to our channel here to get more free content on YouTube. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next video.